Morning, student. How are you?
Fine.
I'm also fine. As you all know, we are at home due to coronavirus disease. So, we are starting study from home. So, today we will tell you the topic nutrition in plant. This is the first chapter of science in class 7th. Student, in previous chapter you have learned the all living things need food. So why do we need, first of all, the question is arises, why do we need to food? So food give us energy to do work, to stay healthy. In this way we can say that we need food for various activities. Now the nutrition, we will read the nutrition in plants. There are the three types of the nutrition in plants. First is autotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition. Second, heterotrophic nutrition. Saprophytic nutrition. Saprophytic nutritions and also parasitic nutrition is found in our plants. First we will learn the autotrophic nutrition. What is the meaning of the autotrophic? Auto means self. Auto means self and tropic means synthesize. It means we can say that, what do you mean by the autotrophic means? The autotrophic nutrition in which the organism make their own food with the help of the surrounding materials like carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll, and this is called the autotrophic nutrition. The organism show the autotrophic nutrition is called the autotrophs. Everybody know what do you mean by the autotrophic nutrition? The nutrition in which organism make their food themselves with the surrounding, we can say that these are the raw materials like carbon dioxide, water, chlorophylls. These are the raw materials. So in this way we can say that the green plants and some blue green algae show the autotrophic nutrition. Now next thing is the photosynthesis, the process by which the green plants or blue green algae make their own food with the help of these raw materials carrying out by a process is called photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. Okay, what is the meaning of the photosynthesis? Photo means light. Photo means light and synthesize means putting together. Putting together. Okay, everybody know what you mean by the photosynthesis? Photosynthesis by the process in which the green plant make their own food with the help of the raw materials, carbon dioxide, water and chlorophyll, that is called the photosynthesis. Now we will learn the process of the photosynthesis, the in which we can say the carbon dioxide. Now the carbon dioxide combined with water to form the glucose plus H2 plus oxygen, and this is the sunlight and chlorophyll. Okay, now the plants, what is the use of the carbon dioxide in plants? Carbon dioxide combined with the water help form the glucose, water and plus oxygen. Where it comes from? Where the plant take from carbon dioxide? Plant take the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and where the plant take the water. Everybody know the plant take the water from the soil. Everybody know what is the function of the roots. This plant root absorb the water and mineral from the soil, and the movement of the water in plants in upward direction only in upward direction, and this work is done by the root. Root absorb the water and minerals from the soil. So water is absorbed by the plant through the roots in upward direction. Now the what is the function of the chlorophyll and where is present? Chlorophyll is present in a green leaves. It is present in a chloroplast. Chlorophyll, what is the function of the chlorophyll? Chlorophyll trap the sunlight. What is the function of the chlorophyll? Chlorophyll trap the sunlight and trap and convert into a chemical energy for the making their food. Now in next, where this process is continued, this process is continued in a plant in a leaves. This is the leaf. Everybody know it is a kitchen of the plant and food factory of the plants. Plant make their own food with this leaf. It is a food factory of the plant. The main function of the leaf, the it make the food. And whenever the need of the food, this leaf transport the food, whether it is roots, stem, bud, fruit. You can see the roots of the plant which we eat, like the radish, carrot. So it transport in all direction. If we talk about the water, and I have talked about the waters, water is transported by the root in only upward direction, only upward. Root absorb the water and minerals, and stem is in transport by any other parts. But if we talk about the transport of the food, transport of the food from the leaves in all parts of the plants, so we can say that it is the other word, we can say the translocation. What do you mean by the translocation? Transport of the food from the leaves to the all part of the plant, whether it is downward, upward and lateral. So everybody know the leaves. If we talk about the leaves, the down surface of the leaves, the tiny pores present in the leaves, that is called the stomata. What is the function of the stomata? Stomata helps in the transpiration. And if we talk about the guard cell in a stomata, this is the guard cell. This is the stomata. Tiny pores. And this is the guards helps in the closing and opening of the stomata. Whenever the water is required in plant, it opens and water is absorbed by this stomata. And whereas there is no need of the water, it closed. So it means we can say that the opening and closing of the stomata is carried out by the stomata. Okay, if you have any problem, any queries, and I will send you assignment for this nutrition in plants, only autotrophic nutrition. Tomorrow we will read the heterotrophic nutrition. Now everybody know what you mean by the autotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition means this is the nutrition in which the organism make their food themselves by the raw materials, carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll. In the presence of the sunlight, that is called the autotrophic nutrition. The organism that show the autotrophic nutrition is called the autotrophs. Now everybody know the nutrition. Everybody know what do you mean by the food? What do you mean by the nutrition? The nutrition means taking in food and utilization in our body, that is called the nutrition. Okay.